Alright guys, I'm going to go over AutoMark and batch hyperlinks. I know you've probably seen videos on this before, I've even pushed some out there, but I'm going to ask you to stick around till the end. I'm going to show a couple more tools. So I'm going to jump over here into my left panel. I'm looking at my drawings that I got from the architect, and my page labels are all incorrect. I've got even four number twos here, so it makes it impossible to navigate these drawings. So at the top of the thumbnails, I'm going to go to the Create Page Labels, and I'm going to select a region, come down here to my title block, and I'm going to draw a box to fill the area. In case that number grows, I want it to still fit inside that box, and I'm going to say OK here, and I'm going to do the whole set, so OK. And just like that, it relabeled all of my documents so that it reads that corner of every one of the sheets and reports the number that's on those drawings. Okay, so now we're going to go up to File and Batch. This is going to be an extreme version only, all the batch tools. We're going to go to New, and I'm just going to pick on Open Files, Next. Since we already fixed the page labels, I'm going to keep that selected. I got my preview here. Everything looks the way I want, so I'm going to say generate. Now with this, a tip I like to show when I teach these, none of the drawings are ever going to say refer to G100. So I'm going to replace that and put in the project number, because that's on every sheet. And by doing that, I'm creating kind of a home button. So I'm going to hit run here. Going to take about, I don't know, 10-15 seconds, and there it created 164 hyperlinks. So I'm going to say finish, and I set mine up to be custom so they'd all look highlighted. And here's where I want you to kind of stick around and watch the rest of this workflow here. We've all seen it this far where you get your hyperlinks hooked up, you can jump from drawing to drawing and follow your way down the path to those. And then here's the home button I created. As I went through there, don't forget these buttons down here. They'll allow you to jump to your previous view, so you can jump back. If you forgot something on the plan where you saw that section cut, you can always go through those again. Also, now that I've got my hyperlinks, I can close that. I don't need that anymore. And I'm going to come over here and look at my hyperlinks list. So here's where it lists all my hyperlinks that we created on the whole document. And I'm just going to do a select all. And then I'm going to go over to one of my hyperlinks and right click. And I'm going to go to layer and create a new layer. I'm going to call it hyperlinks. Okay. And now you can see, I'm going to close that, open the left side back up, and now you can see when I go to my layers tab, I can now turn these on and off. And I would do that because the way that I have them highlighted, if I ever print these to a hard copy, this is going to show up shaded, and we don't want that. So you can turn those off. But what I would encourage you to do, so that you don't have to do that manually, just right click on your layer now and go down to layer properties, and we're going to go to print here and turn it off. Now those highlighted hyperlinks can stay active on my sheet and I don't have to see them when I print. If you have any questions, let me know. Thanks.